Hi guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate.
My name's Ryan Speck. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Rockwood Windjammer 3025. Welcome back to the Great Outdoors RV Company. Today we're going to talk about some of the really cool special features on the Rockwood Windjammer 3025W.
Some of the things I really like about this one, Ryan, is one, the nose. You have a very aerodynamic front to be able to avoid a couple bugs anyway.
Yeah, you know what's crazy about that is in the horse trailer industry, they've been utilizing this tongue for years and years, and the Windjammer is the first one to really come along and utilize that in the RV world, and I really like what they do with that.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. So on the inside here, they give you a double sink, which is pretty unique in a travel trailer setting.
It really is. So you've got his and her sinks in the bathroom, which they accommodate that by putting it in this front cap. A really nice big bathroom, lots of storage. We'll go over some of that when we get inside. Some of the other features that are unique to this floor plan, really nice big island kitchen.
Yeah, it gives you a lot of counter space to work with. And the living room set up ideally to be able to see the TV and have big vista windows.
Yeah, everybody's gonna have a good seat at the TV. You're not kind of looking through the kitchen to look at the TV. Right. Mom could be in there, you know, cooking the dinner, and daddy could be over here watching his sports, and everything is, you know, functional.
Absolutely. Let's talk about some of the construction on this guy.
All right, so it's gonna be a totally vacuum bonded wall. So all your walls are gonna be vacuum bonded. What that means is essentially there's you're gluing fiberglass to your wall when you build it. There's a couple ways of doing that. You can do that the cheap, quick way through a pinch roller, or you can use the more expensive, time-consuming method of a vacuum bonding press that's 10 times less likely to have what's called delamination.
Absolutely. And then when you upgrade to the Windjammer, it's the same level as their Signature Series. And so by doing that, you get, instead of Lamalux 1000 for the fiberglass, you get Lamalux 4000, which gives it that high gel coat gloss to it.
And that's going to help keep you from oxidation and fading down the road. So that's a really nice feature here on the Windjammers. Some of the other things unique to the construction, you're going to have, of course, the solid foam block wall insulation, but you're going to have all aluminum construction that's double welded at every joint.
Absolutely. And then also everywhere that they are putting a screw into the welds, or the aluminum I should say, they put a wood insert there so it has something to bite into that will not loosen over time.
Right, so it's not going to wiggle its way loose. Let's take a walk around this Windjammer and point out some of the features that we've got on it.
So to start off with, power tongue jack with a light here and a second light here to be able to get on and off your ball very easily, as a manual override.
Yeah, we're not always hooking up in the middle of the day or unhooking in the middle of the day, so that's a nice feature. Not only are you not cranking, but you've got that light there to make it easier.
Yeah.
So another really cool feature here, they've got your propane tanks in here enclosed. They're not just exposed up on the tongue of the trailer. So they're in here enclosed. It's going to protect the cylinders. You got two of the big 30-pound cylinders. And you'll notice here, I don't have a little plastic clippy holding open the door. In the Signature Series, which the Windjammer is of that line, everything is all now magnetic. And so it's just a lot more easy and a lot more convenient.
Yeah, those clip kinds seem to get brittle over time and break.
And you forget that you've got them there and you break them yourself.
Yeah.
Stuff that we see all the time here in the RV industry. Let's take a walk around towards the front. And one of the other things I'll point out, we've got power stabilizer jacks.
Yeah, power stabilizer jacks underneath there, as well as a fully enclosed and heated underbelly. They have 12-volt heat pads on them that are rated down to negative 11 degrees.
Another really cool thing they started doing the last couple seasons, you are pre-wired for solar panels. That's a really cool feature. It's just a plug and play system. We sell them in our parts store anywhere from 40 up to 160 watts, just kind of depending on the application you need. They got their own little tripod so you can maximize the light that they're getting. A really neat feature, and then they just kind of fold up into their own little briefcase carrying case.
Yeah. This particular coach has the, not platinum, but the diamond package on it. And so that includes a few things for you. One, it's got that nice tan color to it. Two, it has the
Frameless bonded windows.
Yeah, so that makes it so that there's no rubber piece in the middle here that dries up over time. And the thing I really like is the metal capped awning to protect your awning fabric.
Yeah, I mean, it's an automatic metal wrap. When you bring that awning in, it'll automatically wrap it, and it's going to protect that one strip from getting weathered and sun faded that you see over time with any awning.
Yeah, after a couple of years even.
Right. Another really cool feature at that awning, if you kind of look closely, you can see there's a strip of LED lights runs the full length of that awning. It gets really bright, provides a lot of light, but it doesn't get hot, so it's not going to be attracting the bugs.
Absolutely. As we continue on, this does have a grill that comes with it and a little table so that you can be enjoying the outdoors and not making your camper smell like steak and fish for the next three camping trips.
Yeah, so you've got that outdoor kitchen feature without giving up some of your interior space for the outdoor kitchen like you do on a lot of units, where you kind of give up some interior space to accommodate an outside kitchen. These guys just have one that just simply clips on right there, and it's a pretty good sized grill. I mean, three steaks or, you know, eight burgers, you could easily accommodate.
Outside speakers as well as a radio antenna for your radio.
Yeah, so that's going to pick up, you know, your AM, FM stations. You've also got hookups for your television on the outside. You've got your coax cable that's wired back to your TV antenna, and you've also got power out here. So if a guy wanted to, you could bring your TV out and enjoy it out under your nice awning.
This little sticker here reminded me of the Superflex Alpha roof membrane. So instead of having, it's got a 12-year warranty on it, the best warranty you can get in the industry. And it's more resistant to abrasion. It doesn't chalk like a normal roof will do.
Right.
And it's 30% lighter, so you're not carrying all that extra weight across the entire coach.
Something else I really like with that one-piece membrane that they put on the roof, it matches your exterior color. It's not a white membrane. They've got a membrane that matches the same color of the diamond package here. As we step around the back, we got some other really cool features to talk about on the Rockwood. First thing I'll point out is the ladder. That is a really nice feature to get up and do the maintenance on your roof beginning and end of the season, check all your seals. Not really meant to store anything up there, but it's a nice convenience just having that ladder. You can get up after a long trip and sweep off your slide outs and stuff like that.
Yeah, because when you're bringing your slide ins and everything that's on top of there, water, all that stuff is going into your coach, so it's nice to be able to wipe those off ahead of time.
Absolutely. Another really nice feature here, instead of just a flimsy like vinyl cover on your spare tire, it's a nice hard plastic cover. This is going to stand up over time, where those vinyl covers might last a season or two, especially here in Colorado with some of the extreme weather we have. Final thing I'll point out on the rear of the coach, we do bring them in pre-wired for the Furion backup cameras. Nice convenience. It's just a wireless system that goes into the truck with you. Makes it a lot easier to back into places.
Absolutely. This is also the Furion 30 amp connector. I really like these connectors better than some of the other ones because it has this LED light that lights up when you're plugging in. So if you're not getting power to your coach, you can troubleshoot a lot easier saying, well, I definitely have power to this point at least because this LED light is lighting up.
Right, and the way that Furion plug-in actually screws on and connects, you're not gonna have that popping out, or, you know, the kids running around and accidentally pulling that cord out from the coach.
Right. Yeah, and possible dangers of getting hurt or something like that. These have the slam latch doors throughout instead of the other kind.
The little twist latch, kind.
And then this is storage. This is a huge amount of storage. It's underneath your bed, actually.
Yeah, and you can access that from inside or here on the outside. And again, you've got those nice magnets to hold those doors open. So you're not, again, breaking plastic clippies. It's just a lot more convenient. And yeah, metal slam latches.
And they are metal slam latches instead of the plastic ones like some of the competitors use that break over time.
And not only do they break, they don't latch as properly. Sometimes they kind of stick when you're trying to get them open. So it's just a nice upgrade here. Another thing I'll point out before we move forward is we've got a 6-gallon hot water heater here. It is gas or electric, a direct start ignition. What that means to you as the customer is you're not coming outside lighting a pilot light. You just simply hit the switch inside and you can activate it on either either gas or electricity.
If you're wondering if you can pull this with your truck, this guy weighs 7780, so just under 7,800 pounds dry. Now that doesn't include all the stuff that you might put in here.
Right.
So you probably want to be able to have at least a 10,000 pound half-ton truck.
Yeah, I would say so. And I mean, you're probably looking anywhere from 8 to 1,000 pounds of cargo, just depending on how much you load it up and how much water you're planning on carrying on board. Speaking of water, a really cool feature on the Rockwoods, they come with a 10,000 gallon water filtration system. Nice thing with that, you don't have to haul all that water where you're going. You can get as close to camp as possible, then fill your tanks, knowing that all your water, your toothbrush, your shower, your sink, it's all going to be filtered down to 0.9 microns.
Yep. Another cool thing I just noticed as well is the aluminum rims that are nitrogen filled, radial tires, and torsion suspension.
Yeah, that torsion suspension is a big upgrade over the just regular spring leaf. You're gonna have pendant suspension on both of your tires is going to make for a lot smoother ride.
Absolutely. Let's go inside and show some features inside there.
Absolutely. Here at the Great Outdoors, we're sitting inside of the interior of the Rockwood Windjammer 3025W.
These are the theater seating that are right across from the TV that comes with the unit. I love that you have the drink holders here, the little storage spot for your remotes.
Yeah, they do a really good job of just thinking of the little stuff. A few things I'll point out as we sit here, we've got independent little reading lights that have their own activation button for both seats in the theater seating. Another really nice thing I could point out as I sit here, not only do I have the nighttime shades, but I've also got the privacy shades, so I could still get the light in, but not have people peeping in. Granted, your windows are pretty tinted, but it's a nice feature to have those day and night shades.
Absolutely. As we point over here, this has the pull-out table. It has a little hook. Let's see if I can find where it's at. There's a little hook that holds this. Oh, here it is. On this side, that holds the extension table in. And then this guy just pulls out. So if you do have four adults sitting here, you can have some elbow room to kind of move around, as well as some extra storage underneath these seats.
Yeah, that storage under the seats, I mean, again, just utilizing every little bit of space. And I've been told by several customers that's a great spot for like your owner's manuals and stuff, somewhere that they won't go missing, but somewhere that they're real convenient and easy to get to.
Yeah, or game of cards or something like that too.
I mean, plenty of room. You got room under all four chairs.
And these have the garden windows, so they go all the way down, or atrium windows, I think is another name for them. So they're a little bit bigger, longer, so that you can see outside. And then they do have the opening at the bottom that give you a nice cross breeze if you're sitting out here and just trying to get some air movement.
And that's another nice thing about those frameless windows is they open up from the bottom, they kind of tip out. So if it's raining a little bit outside, you can still leave them open and get that cross ventilation throughout the coach.
Absolutely. The couch is plenty long to take a nice nap on if you need to, as well as this is the type that folds into a bed. Let's show them how this goes into a bed.
All right, so this is what they call the tri-fold. So this guy essentially will just kind of pop up.
Oh, is it this kind?
And okay. Slide out. Simple, easy, and plenty of room for a couple adults to have a really good nap. And you know, this is essentially a couple's coach, but if you're ever bringing someone along with you, you've got plenty of extra room for guests to sleep.
Yeah, and I like that you can still squeeze by the door here, and you have the second door entry, even if somebody's sleeping here on the bed.
That's right. And it just simply slides right back into place there.
Now, the cool thing is, I don't know how they managed to do this, but even with all that cushioning and everything, you still have a slide-out storage tray to be able to put blankets and pillows and stuff like that.
Yeah, all your extra linens for the guests, a great spot for those.
Yep.
And again, lots of abundant overhead cabinetry. You'll notice on all your doors here, they're real solid wood. Your hinges are hidden. They're not exposed hinges. They're nice French door hinges that are hidden on all the cabinetry here throughout the Rockwood Windjammer.
You know, I love that they've done like the arched raised panel cabinetry instead of just the square. It kind of matches this roof that is also barreled right, to wick away the water, but also makes this room feel a little bit more open.
Yeah, and you can really notice the barrel in the roof here. When you look at the line above this overhead cabinetry, you can really see they've really barreled that roof for interior space, rain shed, everything that Mate was talking about.
Yep. These are movable as far as the air conditioning vents, and they're closable. So you can point all the cold air one direction. You can spread it out through the coach more evenly. You can point it all and so that it's all concentrated so that you can really get a full utilization of your upgraded AC that's a 15K AC instead of a 13.5.
Another nice feature on that air conditioner has what's called the quick cool feature. You can actually open it up right here instead of forcing that air through the ductwork to cool the whole coach. It's going to dump right here in the living room area, and it's going to cool it off a lot quicker.
Speaking of cooling off, you can put some cool beverages into your gas electric refrigerator. This is a little bit larger refrigerator. It has 17% more capacity than the retro style hands that you see that have the push button deal. Mm-hmm. This is 17% bigger capacity, and it runs off both propane and 110 power, automatically switches over, has a digital display to be able to set that temperature, as opposed to the little sliding thing that you see that's on the metal grates inside the refrigerator.
And another nice feature on this fridge, we bring it in with the raised wood panels on the front to match all the cabinetry and stuff, just continues with the nice elegant look that you've got here in the Rockwood. Before we slide further on into the kitchen, want to point out the entertainment center here. Great location, right across from the couch and the theater seating. TV mount is movable. It does angle around, so you can aim it all around the coach. Right below it, too, you've got the really nice electric fireplace, which is also a heater, rated to heat 400 square feet. So if you're somewhere with hookups or running a generator, that'll save you a lot of propane.
Also, this is one of the nicest stereo systems as well, because it has the DVD player, CD player, MP3 player, SD card, audio in, video in, HDMI, USB, Bluetooth. You can even download an app for your phone. It has everything.
Yeah, indoor, outdoor speakers that'll play off of it.
Surround sound.
It's a really nice system that Rockwood uses in all their coaches.
Yeah, well, at least in their signature series, and they use a slightly different one for their Ultras and their Roos and stuff like that. These are true Corian countertops. So not the cheese ball solid surface countertops that people sometimes use. This is Corian. This is the DuPont name brand one that's kind of like tissue and Kleenex. Solid surface and Corian go to hand in hand. Stainless steel sink.
Another nice thing about this sink, you've got the split surface here in the sink with the nice Corian covers, but this is not a plastic sink. This is what they call stone cast. So if you accidentally put a hot pot or something in there, it's not gonna melt right through it. And you have those two separate areas to do your cleaning. And if you'll notice, a lot of guys will give you the split sink, but they're both these small ones. The nice thing with Rockwood, they give you that big one for your bigger pots and pans.
I don't know if you've seen it, and maybe this is bad to say this as anti-selling, but I noticed one of the newer Rockwoods that are coming in.
Yeah.
They don't do the stone casted sink. I'm a little sad about that.
Yeah, I saw a plastic sink and I was a little disappointed, but I'm sure there's a method to the madness.
So. Sure, sure. We'll figure it out hopefully in the near future.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Yep. This has the glass stovetop. So it makes for a nice spot to put knives in the back here, as well as a backsplash, as well as extra counter space to work with.
You might notice by your cooktop, you do have the metal blinds, unlike the day-night shades everywhere else. There's a reason behind that. It's because of fire codes. You don't want that cloth by the cooktop.
Yep. These are the soft closed drawers. So as you get close to the last inch of it closing, it'll automatically close for you.
Yeah, pull itself shut, and that will give you confidence that going down the road, those aren't going to come popping open and dumping stuff throughout the coach.
Which unfortunately happens to a lot of different coaches out there.
It does.
If you don't have the soft closed doors.
And you've got a really nice Magic Chef microwave here. Great for popping that popcorn, you know, defrosting that steak before you throw it on your little grill that hooks on the outside.
And that's a nice size pantry too.
It really is. A lot of guys will give you what looks like a pantry and you open up the doors and it's like an inch or two. Yeah. So this is nice. You got a lot of storage in here.
Oh, and then let's talk about this sticker right here. So this says 24-hour, 7-day a week roadside assistance included with vehicle purchase. They give you an emergency phone number here. It's 1 year from date of purchase. It's called CoachNet, and you can call them up, and it's a nice thing. Any Forest River product that you buy, it comes with CoachNet.
It's almost like a AAA service for your RV, and I believe you can continue it after that first free year. It's just a nominal fee.
Right.
Well, let's head into the bedroom and cover some of the features in there, and then we'll talk about the awesome bathroom on this one.
Yes, absolutely. So you'll notice inside here, I can walk all the way to the edge of the coach to be able to make the bed up. This is a residential queen size Serta mattress. So not a cheap entry level mattress that you see on a lot of the other RVs out there.
Yeah, the nice thing here too, you do have a little bit of a nightstand on each side of the bed. Again, the nice day night shades. And just like out by your theater seating, two little reading lights that are independently controlled. So if mama wants to stay up and read while daddy crashes, that's easily accomplishable here. And again, nice big overhead cabinetry. They're able to do that because they use that flush floor on the slide out.
Yeah, that makes a huge difference. And I like that these windows are also openable. So you have three windows in this bedroom area that you can create a nice cross breeze deal through this camper.
Yeah, a window on each side of the bed can really help that ventilation come through and keep it cool in here. And then you've also got, when we opened up the door on the outside to show you the underbed storage, I want to show you how you can access that here from the inside. Really nice too, they've got these little air pistons that'll hold it up for you, so you don't have to hold it up with your back while you're trying to get in there. And you'll notice, not only is your structure aluminum, everything is going to be framed out in aluminum here in the Rockwoods, even the bed. If we had the booth dinette, it would be framed out in aluminum. A lot of guys will brag about an aluminum structure, but then everything inside is, you know, basically one by one wood framed.
Yeah, and these drawers are huge underneath here, so you have tons of room. And these are what we were talking about for the wood inserts. So if you look right here, this is what they do around the perimeter of the coach too, because they are screwing into here. So they'll put a wood insert in there to bite into.
Yeah, you need something for that screw to bind to, because it'll just back out if it's just screwed into the aluminum.
Which unfortunately there are guys who do that in the industry still.
There definitely are. Another here in the Windjammer, more and more storage. Look at all these storage drawers here you've got in the bedroom. Nice big deep drawers at the bottom, and they again continue with the soft close on the drawers. Really good storage up above as well, and you continue using the nice upgraded French hinges. Let's slide on into the bathroom and cover what I think is probably one of the best features about this coach.
Yeah, and I don't know if you've already pointed it out or noticed, but this also has a 12 volt outlet here, as well as a couple USB outlets too for your phone charging if you need it.
Yeah, if you're out dry camping, you can still keep your devices charged up. So look at two full grown men standing here in the bathroom pretty comfortably, and we've still got a really nice large shower off to the side.
Yeah, absolutely. So I could be doing my thing and you doing your thing at your sink, and mm-hmm. I have my own medicine cabinet. You have your own medicine cabinet.
It's a really nice feature here on the Rockwood. And again, plenty of storage. Look at all that linen closet space here in the Rockwood.
Oh yeah, so down here you have some. You have some over here. You have
as well
some over
as
there.
This sink, yeah, plenty of storage throughout the bathroom. Some of the best storage I've seen in any travel trailer's bathroom.
And this has the high-powered MaxAir vent fan with the vent cover over it too. That fan is awesome, so you can suck out a lot of moisture from the shower if you're taking a shower.
Right.
Also, I mean, you can even turn this fan on and crack a window in your bedroom, and it will create enough of a breeze throughout the camper, up to a 10 mile per hour breeze. Usually they give you a tiny little fan about this big, and that creates about 25 cubic feet of air per minute of movement. This one does over 920 cubic feet of air per minute.
That's right. And I'm going to go ahead and step on into the shower, because this is a huge, really nice neo-angle shower that they've got in the bathroom of the Rockwood Windjammer. And for those taller guys, we do bring it in with the skylight. If you're over 6'2", 6'3", you're probably going to be up in there a little bit. But a really, really nice big bathroom, or big shower, I should say, here on the Rockwood Windjammer. Another thing that's cool about the way they do this, so you've got a 6-gallon hot water heater. They've gotten smart about it. They've got a little on-off switch here on the faucet. So once you reach temperature, get yourself all wet, shut it off here, lather up, turn it back on, and the water is going to maintain that temperature you'd got it set to. So you're not wasting hot water trying to dial it in.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, these guys are hard to beat. So they have the bow floor throughout the coach, which minimizes the carpet and the dirt that you're going to get in here. They have the nice little night lights at all your entry points so that you can see what you're doing in the middle of the night. This, by the way, is that
little prep table.
Yeah, prep table that goes next to your grill.
So that kind of covers it for some of the features here on the Rockwood Windjammer 3025.
Visit us.
Yeah, we appreciate you stopping by and visiting us on the web. Come see us in person at the Great Outdoors.
Yeah, my name is Mate.
My name is Ryan Specht, and around here we work like a team. So if you come and see us, we'll all do everything we can to make sure you're taken care of.
Absolutely.